Jason Buck here. How are you guys doing? As all our servers are doing well. Welcome to part 11 of my walkthrough for Horizon Zero Dawn. If you guys didn't see part 10, I'll have a link for that in the description. But basically, in part 10, we made it to Meridian, finally. And now we're actually going to find Olin, and hopefully he can spread some light on exactly what's going on. You know, why was he working with the traitors and stuff like that. And also, we're going to try and find Aaron and help him identify the people who killed his sister, who, if I'm correct in assuming, should be the people who Olin was working for. So let's go ahead and jump into it, hopefully it doesn't take too long to get to Olin, which is where we're going here. Get some herbs. And off we go. Is there anything along the way I should stop at? The campsite. I totally looked at me and just looked away.
Red light.
Just try one of those. Actually, wasn't too hard to take down. That's what they're doing. It gets in my way. It looks like it's going to.
More than a perfect if you want.
You know this can move. So I was looking it up, and apparently there's about 22 chapters or main quests in the game, and there's a bunch of side quests as well. So I think I'm about maybe 10, 11 quests as far as the main chapter goes. So you know, about halfway, sounds about right. Get back here. So, we're already on episode 11, or part 11, or whatever, episode part something. So it shouldn't take too much longer to finish the main part of the game. And then I'll go back and, gotta find some of the cauldrons again. Do some of the side missions. Fox bone. I need fox skin so I can get the,
those legs?
You plucked me from death's grasp. Thank you.
Everybody give me something, guy. I wasn't free.
The sun showed us the way.
This is not gonna give me anything? Like, at all? So... I'm gonna go get this campsite next. At some point, I want to try and override a sawtooth now that I have the ability from the cauldron. Maybe if I get close enough to one that's along the path. Ravager. Well, these are the bad guys.
What's that?
Headshot didn't kill him? What? This guy's totally oblivious to what happened.
Come on!
Full already.
Stay away from those. Already have this camper. I guess just by getting close to it, I automatically trigger it. Just in case. So we're gonna go straight to find to Aaron at Red Ridge Pass and have him help him figure out who killed his sister. What was that? This place looks mad sketchy. Like, I really shouldn't.
These are helpful. Bitter. It's Aaron. And he's in trouble.
Glad that's over with. Thanks for the help.
I didn't help you, but yeah, sure.
Come on over here and have a word.
Get some more herbs.
Hardy little plant. You'll help.
Come on, what are you waiting for?
Chill, bro. I'll help myself to some of this.
What are you doing out here all alone? Where are your men?
I'm not gonna risk their lives. I don't mind putting my worthless ass on the line, but not theirs. Sorry I had to drag you into it.
Don't worry. This is just an average day for me. You know, take down some machines, track some killers.
Right. I'd hate to see a busy morning for you. Ready to get started?
Are you sure you're all right?
Well, I'm sober, so... no.
Well, I'm glad you're thinking straight at least.
Don't get used to it.
Tell me exactly what happened to Ursa. Start from the beginning.
No one knows for sure. She left in the middle of the night with a few of her best men.
Her best men? But she didn't bring you?
No. I'd been drinking a lot. And maybe she thought Damn, I don't know. I couldn't hack it. Search parties found their bodies the next day and the corpses of some Shadow Carja cowards. It was an ambush. The Shadow Carja are animals. They beat her so bad we can't even show her face before burial.
I'm so sorry, Erend.
Yeah, well, when I find the soldiers who did this, they'll be sorry too.
You don't have any idea why she left in the middle of the night?
No. But it must have been urgent. A message, a report of some new Shadow Carja threat, I don't know.
Why would the Shadow Carja do this?
Because they hate us. And Ursa most of all. She teamed up with Avad to kick their asses out of Meridian. They've been licking their wounds for 2 years, but they finally found a way to get back at her.
All right. Show me where Ursa fell, and I'll do what I can to help.
Come on, follow me.
Sounds pretty brutal.
Got one. Why would Ursa come all the way out here?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense.
Is this Shadow Carja territory?
No. They broke the ceasefire as soon as they set foot in the cleft.
Where is this guy leading me? Damn.
Almost there.
Not like you heard me. Nice.
Hey, this is it. Where the ambush happened. Our soldiers have been over it, but maybe that fancy artifact of yours can find a clue or something. Please. I need to find the bastards that did this.
They look like smears. It must be Shadow Carja armor. Strange. Not a scratch on it.
Could this be like a fake killing?
These look like drag marks. Did someone move a body through here?
What do you see there?
This stain forms a line, as if blood dripped off the edge of something, like a cart. See? Cart tracks. I think someone moved the bodies here, then scattered them across the field.
Wait. Are you saying the dead found here were killed somewhere else? But why would the Shadow Carja do that?
At this point, I'm not taking it for granted that the Shadow Carja are responsible.
Of course they were.
Well, let's follow these tracks and find out.
Out just in case there's a fight coming up. Kind of think maybe I should have done the main mission first before doing this one. Find Olin. But we already started this one, so might as well see it through to completion.
I get why they wanted Ursa dead. Why pick an ambush?
There's more to this. And we're gonna figure it out.
Far does this go, bruh?
No space.
a satellite?
These guys aren't Shadow Carja. They're from my tribe, the Oseram.
Is this how your people usually greet each other?
She's coming for us!
Oh, why would you come here? Oh, what?
What's that?
I think it's calling in machines. Get ready, hippie.
You made a big mistake!
Machines. I have to kill the other one too. Damn. Can you just hope it's in your way? Oh, he's already going after it. Jeez.
Oseram, not Shadow Carja. Looks like I was wrong about everything, as usual. Please, use that second sight of yours. I have to know what really happened.
I'm on it.
Scavenge this thing?
So much blood. What are those leather straps? A lot of people died here. A massacre. Armor straps. Cut with a knife. And a rock with blood on it. These look like Vanguard weapons. Those rocks, they're shattered. Something hit these stones. Something I've never seen before.
Might not be a good
There's
thing.
No blood on them. Ursa's men didn't fight back.
So are the things we did. What if he was in on it, this guy?
Looks like you could mount some equipment on that thing.
You mean like attacked his sisters. I don't know.
There, by the tripod. A used power cell.
This is Ursa's helmet. I thought she died in the field below, but must have been here. All this trickery. For what? Feels like it's just a torture me.
Maybe he's sincere.
I have a theory. But it takes a little imagination.
So far, your theories are better than other people's facts.
All right. I think the Oseram ambushed Ursa and her men with a new weapon. They mounted it on that tripod up there. It fires waves of force, maybe sound. Looks like it cracked the stone there. I think it paralyzes people instead of killing them. It dropped the vanguard right there. No blood on their weapons. No fight.
But why paralyze them if you're only gonna move them and gut them?
They were trying to hide something. Look here, a bloody rock.
That they used to smash Ursa's face in.
Or someone else's. These leather straps have been cut, as if they took the armor off someone.
That can't be. Her body is lying in state in Meridian. I saw it.
You said she was unrecognizable.
One of my theories was right.
Maybe they switched another body into her armor, someone around the same size, and mutilated it enough so it could have been anyone, even Ursa. Go back to Meridian. Take another look at that body. If it's really Ursa, of course I'm wrong. But if I'm right...
Then my sister could be alive. I'm going. Meet me back there when you can.
Wouldn't that mean his sister is part of the... I don't know. Could she be evil? To go talk to Olin, so let's go do that.
Save these for the trail.
Hey, level 19. I only have 2 skill points. I can only get one of these. That'd be cool. I think I'm saving it for this though, Leader Strike. Maybe I should keep things balanced. I'll go for Combat Override. Override. Alright, so we just ended up fast traveling to one of the closer campfires. And then from here we'll end up just going to here. I'll mark this in the trail just so I know where to turn. Pretty much maxed out my herb usage. Alright, so from here I can just go down to here. At least there might be some enemies over here, but hopefully not too much. Enter the excavation site. Find us.
I'd have to leave something else behind.
Let's see. Yep, people down here. Only 2, so it shouldn't be too bad. Oh, but then there's that thing.
This is what you intend, to bring these ancient things back to life.
Their power serves us.
Machine demons from beneath the ground. It It's a nightmare. Nightmares, yes. The worst dreams of our enemies come true. Yes, rise.
That's a little basement. That's what I'm showing them. Oh, bro.
So much for catching him alone.
These things will destroy us all!
They will only destroy our enemies. And bring us back the lands that were taken.
You stop working.
Search the area. We may have intruders.
Forgive this intrusion, Aloy. You left me no choice.
Who is this?
An interested party. Now their focuses are disabled, but I don't know for how long. The rest is up to you.
Who is this?
That guy sounded mad familiar, like another video game that I played. I looked it up, dudes. You should be safe from up here, right? There's no one up here that can get me. Switch to fire.
You had your chance.
Zelda, they drop off a little bit. Thing.
He really moved out of the way now. He's still alive somehow. I totally just kind of took the easy way out by camping my ass up on the ledge. I'll have to kill that guy that's up there somehow. Oh. You're going. Come back here. You and I need to have a chat. Oh, I guess we can't do anything until that guy's dead. Come out.
They're still looking.
Do you really want me to go all the way back up just so I can get this guy? Light him on fire just for him being annoying. The bro doesn't really want to come out, huh? That's what you get. Where you at, Olin?
I promise. I'll tell you everything.
I know you will. The killers who came for me at the Proving, who are they?
The Eclipse. Some kind of holy warriors. A cult of the Shadow Carja.
Shadow Carja?
Except they're not like any Carja I've known. They don't pray to the sun. They worship some kind of devil.
I'm not interested in their superstitions.
Oh, it's not a superstition. Their devil is real. It has a name, a voice, the most terrible voice, and they do its bidding.
You say this devil, the Eclipse worship, has a name?
Hades. That's what they call it.
Hades. And you've heard it speak?
Steel to my soul, I heard. Just once, when it saw you. Such a voice. A cold, awful jangle. It scrapes your bones. It hollows your guts. A metal sound, but like nothing dug from the earth or smelted in a forge.
And what did it say?
System threat detected. Just three words. But in the voice of a devil.
Huh.
Why are the Eclipse digging up ancient machines? And how do they get them to work?
I thought they wanted them for scrap, but they brought them back to life. Plugged some kind of device into the corpses so that Hades could whisper to them and call them from their grave.
I've fought that kind of machine before. Are there others?
Yes. The ones you fought today they call corruptors, but there are others. Much bigger, bristling with ancient weapons. Those they call Deathbringers. I've only seen them buried in the ground. But after today, anything is possible.
Sounds to me like they're raising an army.
Deathbringers.
If so, the world will fall. And I helped dig the pit.
What are these Eclipse cultists after, besides me?
They never said. But given the Karja civil war, they must want to overthrow Sun King of Ard and take Meridian back.
What do I have to do with that?
I don't know.
When they attacked the Proving, a man came for me. Tall, strong, dead eyes.
Helis.
And who is he?
The Terror of the Sun. Stacker of corpses, we Osseron called him when he was the Mad Sun King's champion. If only he'd died with his king. But now he leads the Eclipse. I tell you, he's the most dangerous man alive.
How did the Eclipse recruit you? I know they took your family hostage, but why you?
I was a scrounger, a rummager in dark places, good at what I do. I suppose they knew I would serve them well as a scout. I had taken a delve near Maker's End. When I surfaced, they were waiting. I laughed when I saw the priest, but then he showed me Helis's encouragement. I didn't laugh after that. They gave me a focus to watch my every move. I followed orders.
You had access to Meridian. Why didn't they get to Avad through you?
Too much dirt under my nails for an audience with the one true Sun King. But whatever Ursa or Aaron told me, the Eclipse heard every word through my focus. That's why I couldn't warn you. If I'd tried, they would have killed my family.
The Eclipse were sent to kill me because I look like another woman. Older, maybe twice my age, short hair. Who is she?
I don't know. My focus found her image once, in the ruins at Maker's End. Maybe you can find her there.
You found her image in the ruins? How?
There was a door beside it, a kind of ancient device that contained the woman's image. My focus recorded the location. You do look like her. Is she your mother?
I'm the one asking questions. I've heard enough. It's time to finish this.
I won't beg for my life. But if there's any mercy in you, free my family. Please.
Where would I find them?
My focus recorded the location. There are always guards there. You look like you can handle yourself.
It will take many good deeds to make up for the crimes you've committed.
You're sparing me? After all I've done?
Yes. Forge a new life, Olin. One of better make.
Then the rest of my life will be lived in your debt.
Go to the place where your family is being held and wait for me. We'll make their lives the first ones you save.
I didn't earn this mercy, but I will die to make myself worthy of it. I will be waiting for you.
I don't see the point in killing him. I mean, come on. The guy was kind of forced to do all these things because his family was taken. You know, there would be... I don't really see the point in killing him. Nothing would come of it. Right? So... Plus, he can be of, hopefully, use in the future. Go meet Aaron and then,
The shadow part of the world, and now the world.
This place is actually pretty tight, I'm not gonna lie. Like, for a place that's, like, thousands of years in the future, they really did basically just rebuild, like, a Mayan civilization. I gotta give props to Guerrilla Games. This is pretty tight, I'm not gonna lie. treat me like royalty when I come in.
No one goes into the palace without an invitation.
Wait, what? You just invited me.
Greetings, Aloy. I am known as Blameless Murad. Please come with me. You're needed for an important consultation.
What do you mean? Where's Erend?
He's inside, attending the Sun King, where we should be without further delay. Follow me, please.
All of these people are here to see the Sun King.
Yes, and each has come to ask a favor of him. Unpleasant, but that's politics. The Sun King is eager to meet you, the machine tamer with a curious eye for detail. It's all very intriguing.
I'm not here to intrigue you.
Too late.
First the Oseram get special treatment, and now outlanders from the savage East.
What possible interest could the
Sun
King
have in her? What'd you say? You have a problem with me?
Passed by some outlander woman.
Amazing, get in front of me. Damn right I get to the front of the line.
Ignore them. Nobles are like children who whine when they don't get a second helping of dessert.
What's the Sun King like?
The most important thing is what he isn't like. His father. I think you'll find him to be a reasonable man.
Oh, there's a thing here for me to scan.
Aloy of the Nora. She who sees the unseen. Welcome. It would seem you have done me a great service. Erend, tell her what you found.
I checked Ursa's tomb. You were right, Aloy. The body is missing a scar below her right knee. I gave it to Ursa when we were kids, fighting over a toy sword.
If the body is not Ursa's, then we must assume she is still alive. And I will not abandon her.
We only know she was taken, not who took her.
I can help with that. Ursa has an enemy among the Oseram. A warlord named Dervahl.
Impossible. Every clan in the claim has been hunting for him since the liberation. He has to be dead by now.
No other Oseram had the motive and ingenuity to lure Ursa into this trap. I expect to find him lurking somewhere near the border. I've already sent an agent to investigate. He'll be waiting for word from us at the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
I can't move troops to the border without provoking the Oseram, but I could send a few vanguardsmen. And perhaps an exceptionally gifted Nora as well? Erend, Murad, let me discuss it with her privately.
Oh snap, private meeting.
I hate to impose further after all you've done, but this is a matter of great importance to me.
It sounds like Ursa means a lot to you.
Without her Oseram vanguard, I would not have been able to liberate Meridian and end my father's brutal reign. Since then, it has been difficult to maintain peace between our tribes. But Ursa has a way of making her people see reason. So you see, I need her back at my side. And quickly.
Who is Dervahl exactly?
To understand Dervahl, you must first understand my father. He truly thought of himself as a sun god. His mind was broken. He believed that blood sacrifice would solve, well, everything. So he raided the other tribes for victims, especially the Oseram. Dervahl fought back. He crafted powerful weapons and rallied his people. My father responded with the ultimate cruelty. He captured Dervahl's wife and daughter and sacrificed them in the Sun Ring.
Oh no.
So, why would Dervahl go to so much trouble to kidnap Ursa?
He felt she betrayed him. She fought by his side until she realized he planned to raise Meridian and butcher its people. Then she came to me. Together, we stopped him and liberated the city from my father. Dervahl has spent every moment since trying to get revenge. Mostly on the other Oseram who fought with us. He made so many powerful enemies, I thought we'd seen the last of him. I was wrong.
I'd like to ask you something about the Sundom and its politics.
By all means.
They call you a sun god who killed his own father in order to unite the tribes in harmony. Is any of it true?
They say you can see the invisible, split an arrow at 50 paces, and tame machines at a glance. How much of that is true?
It's not too far off.
Well, I would like to unite the tribes in harmony, but you saw how many courtiers I have to deal with first. Maybe next week.
Quite a place you've got here. You can almost see the little people below the mesa.
You don't approve? Well, I have a secret for you. Neither do I. But we must be patient. Change won't come in a single sunrise.
But will it happen at all, while men live in palaces?
It might. Eventually. If people like you help me bring it about.
Your politics seem very complicated. The Oseram are friends, but enemies too?
I couldn't have liberated Meridian without the help of Ursa and her Oseram freebooters. Many of them have settled here. But the Ealdermen of the Oseram clans and the Claim have become jealous of their success. So have many Karja nobles. It's a volatile situation, especially given the fact that my father raided the Oseram for years. Ursa helps keep the peace, promising a future based on mutual gain. But some, like Dervahl, will never let go of their venom.
Sorry, I know this is a long one. I'm trying to.
What can you tell me about the Shadow Karja? What do they have to do with Ursa?
They are remnants of my father's regime, holding out at the fortress of Sunfall to the west. Like him, they care only for domination, and seek to draw upon the power of the sun by spilling blood in its name. Since Ursa helped me take this city from them, they were perfect scapegoats. Dervahl knew this, of course, and planned it well.
I need to get going.
I know. Well, they say kings should never beg. But please, help me find Ursa.
Who says that?
Murad, for one. Don't hesitate to ask him or Erend if you have further questions.
All right. This place is pretty cool. Alright guys, that does it for part 11 of my walkthrough for Horizon Zero Dawn. This was a little bit longer of a part. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to drop a like and subscribe if you guys are new so you guys know exactly when part 12 comes out. We're going to continue on with the main story and try to get as many things done. Hopefully we can find Erend's sister and save her. But again, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Until then, take it easy, guys. Peace.